You're from nowhere in particular. Where are you from? Where'd you start out? Where you been living?
That's true. I guess you could say I'm from nowhere, really. My father was in the Army, and we traveled extensively. You know, when I was coming up, I spent a couple of years in Germany, and we always seemed to go back to Tacoma, right outside of Tacoma, Washington. And I'm basically from the Northwest. I spent some time in Eugene, Oregon, which is where we started the band in 1974. I lived in Portland, Oregon for a while. Right now I live in Seattle, Washington. And I'm in a band and we travel all over the place. So I guess you could say I'm from nowhere.
How did you get started playing music?
I got involved with playing guitar in 1965. And it was a result of the British invasion, the Rolling Stones, the Beatles and whatnot. So I got a guitar like everybody else in the neighborhood did back in those days. And I took lessons for a little while, but played again with all kinds of kids in the neighborhood. And I started playing everything that was on the radio, you know. And I got into a rock and roll thing and rhythm and blues. I used to listen to people like Jimi Hendrix and Eric Clapton, Magic Sam and Buddy Guy, people like that.
What were some early things that really influenced you as far as rock and roll? Beatles, Stones, Hendrix, what were some records you remember?
Well, you know, Hendrix's very first record, I Experienced, came out. And the first time I heard stuff like that just really freaked me out. Because I've been playing, you know, we do songs up by the Young Rascals, all the bands did, you know. Louie, and back in those days, you know. And I don't think they were really played any Beatles songs, but we might have played Satisfaction or something like that by the Stones. But it was all the songs that were very simple for us back in those days, you know. And we'd get together in the garage and just mess around. But people like Hendrix, I really liked the soul thing by the Young Rascals, you know. Wilson Pickett doing Midnight Hour, Sam and Dave, Otis Redding, people like that.
Who influenced you as far as blues? There's some people that really stick to you now.
As far as blues, there's so many, you know. On guitar, I really respect Albert Collins. We spent some time working with Albert Collins back in 76 through 78. We were his backup band whenever he was on the West Coast. You know, and then B.B. King, of course, because of his smooth, melodic style of playing. Albert King and the way that he bends strings, I don't think anybody else can do. There's a lot of them. Buddy Guy, Hubert Sumlin with Howlin' Wolf. Yeah.
Why do you think you were attracted to the blues? You know, a lot of young cats, they're in the funk thing, or they're, you know, especially in cities like New York, they're rappers. So what drew you to what you played?
I had to find something that felt comfortable to play. And the kind of blues music is about real life situations, whether it's love or hard times. That's what attracted me to the music. When you listen to somebody like the Howlin' Wolf, and he starts singing with all that power that he's got, when he sings something that he's mad about, I mean, you really know the cat's mad. When he's happy about something, he's happy about that, or he can be really evil.
You know, we've talked about that have been so big. Their music is based on blues, like Clapton's early bands, the music, of course, the music he plays now. And bands like Led Zeppelin had so much success playing really a blues-based kind of music. What do you think of groups like that?
Well, they came from the right place, you know. They came from the right place when they started off playing in their bands, and that's really cool. It's cool in my book. I think it's great. Because I think blues music is it's a good background for anything else that you want to undertake, you know. You really should know how to play some blues first. It's really good to know how to play blues if you want to go into a jazz field, because a lot of jazz songs are based upon blues themes, you know. And so it's a good background.
Who are some rock guitarists that you really like?
Eric Clapton is a big one in my book. Keith Richards. Jimi Hendrix was. Those are probably the biggest ones I'd name off right now. Of course, and then again, I'm from an old school. I'm not too aware of the real current scene.
And you've played with Eric and Keith on stage. In fact, the three of you played together with Chuck Berry, who's from the old school. Tell us about your involvement in the film, the Hail Hail Rock and Roll film.
Yeah, we did the Hail Hail Rock and Roll show in October, and with Eric Clapton and Keith Richards. And I mean, Keith had the band together for, I think, 3 weeks before I arrived, and I walked into the situation where I've never met Keith Richards before.